So now we are going to discuss about redemption of preference shares. So what do you mean by redemption now? First thing comes about redemption. What is redemption? Redemption means getting back. So here who is getting back what? So here company is getting back already issued preference share. So company, usually what happens, company cannot pay back its share capital to its shareholder during its lifetime without the permission of the court. However, company can issue special category of shares. So such shares are known as redeemable preference share. So what is redeemable here? Getting back of the shares. So company first issues the share and subscriber will pay the amount after a certain year. Usually within 20 years, company should redeem the preference share. So whenever company buy back its own share, what company will do? So whether it will buy back the shares at issue price, or whether it will buy back more than the issue price, or it will buy back at discount. So that is the question. So it will buy back either at par or at a premium, but not at a discount. So that is the thing here. So however, company can issue special category of share termed as redeemable preference share, which the company can redeem during its lifetime. So when the company capital is raised by issuing the redeemable preference share, what happens? It is to be paid back by the company to such shareholder after the expiry of stipulated period, whether company is wound up or not. So in this case, what is the stipulated period here? What is the stipulated period in this case? What is the stipulated period? What is the stipulated period here for redemption of preference share? That is 20. That is within 20 years, redeemable preference share must be redeemed. So there are certain rules you must follow before solving the problem. There are certain legal requirements as per the Companies Act. So Companies Act of 1956, before there was Companies Act of 1956. Now they have changed to Companies Act of 2013. So now we need to see the legal requirement of Companies Act of 2013. So first thing is preference shares are to be redeemed, that should be fully paid up. So in the case of partly paid share, what happens? In the case of partly paid shares, what happens? We need to convert that partly paid shares into fully paid shares. So that is the first condition while redeeming the preference share. So what do you mean by partly paid share? So anyone can answer, what do you mean by partly paid share? So what is partly paid share? Anyone can answer here. What is partly paid share? Please unmute yourself and answer. What is partly paid share? What is partly paid share? Anyone can answer. Here. So no answers. What is partly paid shares? What is partly paid share? Suppose there is a face value of share is 100. Face value of share is 100 and only 75 rupees is paid. In that case, what happens? 25 is unpaid value of the share. So that unpaid value, because of that unpaid value, share becomes partly paid. So what is the face value? We need to pay the full amount. 100 rupees. If there is 100 rupees face value, we need to pay the full amount of 100 rupees. If we pay lesser than that, in that case, what happens? That becomes partly paid share. Then capital can be redeemed either out of profits of the company or out of fresh issue of share, but not out of debenture. So simple words, you can say that for the purpose of redemption of preference share, you cannot utilize debenture. You can utilize the fresh issue. Fresh issue means what? New issue is made for meeting the redemption of preference shares and either out of profit. So there will be profit and loss account balance will be given in the problem. You can utilize that balance. And if profit and loss account balance is not given, then you need to go for reserves balance. Reserve. What is reserve here? Separate balance kept aside for meeting any uncertain future event. So your reserve balance, that is general reserve you can use. That is second condition. Then third one. Preference shares are to be redeemed at either at par or at premium, but not at discount. So what do you mean by par and premium? Suppose there is a face value of share is 100. Issuing at premium means now company is paying more because after a certain period, share price also goes up, right? Due to the market events. So what happens? Suppose face value is 100, now premium will be 110 per share. So that is 10 rupee will be your premium. Suppose what is discount? So Suppose 100 is a face value. If company is giving only 90 rupees, so there is a lesser than the original amount. So that is 10 minus 10 will be your discounted value. Par means exact on that face value amount. So that is third condition. Shares are redeemed either at par or at premium, but not at discount. Then fourth one, the premium payable on redemption of preference shares must be provided either out of profit or out of security premiums account. So what is security premium account? So anyone can answer, what is security premium account? Anyone can answer how we can get the balance of security premium account? How we can get the balance of security premium account? How we can get the balance? First thing you need to see whether the shares are redeemed at premium. So if it is redeemed at premium, then next thing you need to see whether there is any fresh issue. If there is any fresh issue, what happens? Then fresh issue of share, how it is made, either at par or at premium. So if it is made at premium, then automatically there will be security premium account balance will come. Then again, in the problem itself, they will give security premium account balance directly sometimes. That we need to see. Then, when the capital is redeemed out of profit, an amount equal to the nominal value of shares redeemed should be transferred to capital redemption reserve account. Capital redemption reserve account is nothing but capital reserve CRR account. So that is CRR account. So why CRR account is maintained? Suppose a company want to pay any bonus shares. Suppose company want to pay any bonus shares. In that case, company can use the balance of CRR account, that is capital redemption account. So what balance you can transfer to capital redemption reserve account? That is the first question. What balance you can transfer to capital redemption reserve? Except the fresh issue of shares. Except the fresh issue of shares, only utilizing the profit you can transfer to CRR, that is capital redemption reserve account. So why I am explaining these all rules? So these rules are necessary while solving the problem. If you don't know this basic rule, then very difficult to solve the problem, because problem means here in this case there is a journal entries and balance sheet you need to do. So that is the fifth point. Then sixth one, capital redemption reserve account may be utilized by the company for the purpose of issuing fully paid bonus shares. So why bonus share is given? Suppose there is extra profit in the company. Suppose there is normal activities done by the shareholder. In case some incentive is given to them, so that is known as bonus shares. Bonus shares, capital redemption reserve balance can be utilized. Then seventh one, the redemption of preference shares should not be taken as a reduction in authorized capital. That means what? Reduction in authorized capital means what? Anyone can answer here. What do you mean by reduction in authorized capital? What do you mean by reduction in authorized capital? Anyone can answer. What do you mean by reduction in authorized capital? What is reduction? Anyone can comment also in the chat box. You can unmute yourself and answer. So reduction of authorized capital is nothing but it is internal reconstruction. So what is internal reconstruction? Without the winding up of the company, what company will do? It will alter the share capital, alter the authorized capital. So if that is the case, then it is known as internal reconstruction. So redemption of preference shares should not be considered as internal reconstruction. That is one more condition. Then company has a power to issue shares up to the nominal number of shares redeemed. So nominal number, up to the nominal number, company can issue the share. If the fresh issues are issued for the purpose of redemption, it will not be treated as increase of capital. So fresh issues are issued only for the purpose of redemption. We cannot consider that as addition to the capital. That is one more point comes under. That is one more point comes for this redemption of preference share. So now next thing, items that can be used for redemption. What and all item we can use for redemption? See, items which can be used, there are several items they have mentioned. First thing is general reserve. That means general reserve balance you can utilize for the purpose of redemption. Dividend equalization fund. Dividend equalization fund balance also you can utilize for the purpose of redemption. Workmen's compensation fund. Suppose any fund is kept for meeting the workmen's contingency, that is also utilized. Debenture redemption fund. Debentures cannot be utilized, but debenture redemption fund you can utilize. Contingency reserve, insurance fund, credit balance, if any, in profit and loss account, that is nothing but profit. So all these items, all seven items, you can utilize for the purpose of redemption of preference share. So that is first thing. Item that cannot be utilized for the purpose of redemption. What and all item now you cannot utilize for the purpose of redemption, that also we need to see. So here, what you cannot utilize for the purpose of redemption? Balance of forfeited shares account. Balance of forfeited shares account you cannot utilize. Then what is forfeited share? What do you mean by forfeited share? Anyone can answer. What is forfeited share? Unmute yourself and answer. What is forfeited share? Anyone? What is forfeited share? What is forfeited share? Anyone can answer. Yes, cancellation. Yes, cancellation. Cancellation means what? Why cancellation is done? For the non-payment of call money. Suppose there is a non-payment of call money, one notice is given, one 14 days notice is given. Again, call money is not paid by the subscriber. In that case, what happens? That money, shares are forfeited. That means cancelled. And such cancelled shares are reissued at a discounted rate. So again, that is given to some other class of sharehold. That is known as forfeited shares. So balance of forfeited shares account cannot be utilized here for the purpose of redemption. Balance of security premium account. Again, security premium account balance, why it is not utilized for the purpose of redemption? Anyone can answer. Why it is not utilized, security premium account balance, for the purpose of redemption? Why security premium is not utilized? Because it is utilized for meeting the redemption premium. So we can use that balance only for redemption premium, not for anything else. For capital purpose, you cannot utilize security premium account. So that is one more thing. Then next thing, balance of capital reserve. Balance of capital reserve, again, you cannot utilize for the purpose of redemption. And profit prior to incorporation. So what is profit prior to incorporation? Anyone can answer here. Profit prior to incorporation means what? Before the registration of the company, if a company earns any profit, such profit cannot be taken for the purpose of redemption. So that is one more condition for redemption of preference share. Now very important thing comes here, accounting treatment. What and all journal entries you need to know and you need to remember before solving the problem, that we must see now. So, accounting treatment, first one, for fresh issue of share on redemption. So that means if there is any fresh issue of share on redemption, in that case what happens? What is a journal entry? What is a normal journal entry when fresh issue is done? That is bank to equity share capital account. So that is money is received and shares are given. So whenever there is an issue of share. So now there are various conditions. Various conditions are there when issued at par. So when shares are issued at par, what is the journal entry? Bank account debit to equity share capital account. Normal journal entry you need to pass. Next, issued at premium. So what do you mean by issued at premium? Above the face value, more than the face value. In that case, bank account debit to equity share capital and security premium account, anyways it is a credit balance. So to security premium account, premium amount you need to write under security premium account. That is issued at premium. Then issued at discount. If shares are issued at a discount, then discount as a debit balance. So bank account debit, discount on issue of shares account debit to equity share capital. So what is a normal entry for issue of shares? That is bank to equity share capital. If there is a premium, then to security premium, that is credit balance. If it is a discount, debit balance, discount on issue of share. So these journal entry very, very important from the point of view of solving the problem. Then from the amount, for the amount due on redemption. So amount due on redemption means what? Anyone can answer. What do you mean by amount due on redemption? What is that? Amount due on redemption means. What do you mean by amount due on redemption? So amount due on redemption means at the time of redemption of preference share, company need to pay back capital first to the shareholder. In this case, who is the shareholder? Preference shareholder. Plus, what is the redemption? Whether now the redemption is made at premium or a discount or at par, that we need to see. If it is at premium, then premium is also paid along with the share capital, that is more than the issue price. So these two balance are given to preference shareholder. So preference share capital account debit, redemption premium account debit to preference shareholder for the amount due on redemption. That is second journal entry you need to know while solving the problem. Now, third one, for payment made to preference shareholder. Now we know what is due to the preference shareholder, how no payment is made, debit the receiver, preference shareholder is a receiver of the money, and from where they are making payment, from bank account. So preference shareholder account debit to bank account, that is for the payment made to preference shareholder. This is the journal entry. Now, next, for meeting redemption premium. So what is the rule for meeting redemption premium? Either out of profits or out of premium, security premium account, you can utilize to pay redemption premium. So security premium account and profit and loss account can be utilized for the purpose of redemption of premium. That is fourth journal entry. If you see the rules above mentioned, the rules are mentioned that we need to carefully see. See this. The premium payable on redemption must be provided either out of profits or out of security premium account. So that is the one more journal entry. Now we know. Then fifth one, for redemption of capital out of profits. So here, other than the fresh issue. So either out of profits, either out of reserves and out of fresh issues, we can utilize the capital for the purpose of redemption. Now, other than the fresh issue we need to take, that is profit and loss account debit, revenue reserve account debit to capital redemption reserve account. That is for redemption of capital out of profits. So that is fifth journal entry. Fifth journal entry you need to know. Then sixth one, after doing all this thing, issue of bonus share. So for the purpose of issuing bonus share, what is used here? Here, CRR balance is used. CRR means what? Capital redemption reserve balance is used. So, when the decision is taken to issue the bonus share, what is the journal entry? Capital redemption account debit to bonus to equity shareholder. That is the journal entry when the decision is taken. When the bonus shares are actually issued, then bonus to equity shareholder, that is bonus shares are given to equity shareholder, that is why that is debited. Bonus to equity shareholder account debit to equity share capital. Bonus shares are issued in the form of equity shares. So these journal entries you need to know before solving the problem. So now we will solve the problem. We'll discuss the problem now. See, next one problem we need to see here. So that now we'll discuss. AB Limited. So first problem, this type of problem comes for 12 marks, or sometimes with lot of adjustment it comes for 24 marks. If it is for 6 marks, then they will ask very minute, less number of adjustment. So AB Limited had 5000 redeemable preference shares of 10 each. Such shares were redeemable at premium of 10%. Then the company issued 2000 equity shares of 10 each at a premium of 2 per share. The company has necessary balance in profit and loss account. Pass the entries to record these transactions. So before solving the sum, we need to see what and all. First thing we need to see, redemption. How redemption is done. Here they have said 5000 redeemable preference shares of 10 each. That means we know the preference share capital now. What is the preference share capital? 5000 into 10, that is what? 50,000. Is a preference share capital. Such shares were redeemed at a premium 10%. So on that 50,000, if you take 10%, you will get the premium amount. Then company issued 2000 equity share. What is that company? Why company is issuing 2000 equity share? That is fresh issue. Fresh issue, why fresh issue is done? For the purpose of redemption. So this is nothing but 2000 equity shares of 10 each, that is fresh issue. Then what is the premium of 2 per share? That is nothing but security premium account. in the fresh issue, fresh issues are done at premium. So there is a security premium account balance. Then company has necessary balance, that means profit and loss account balance is there. So you need to record all these transactions. Before that, I want to ask any doubt in the rules and journal entries. Any doubt in the rules and journal entries, you can ask now. Unmute yourself and ask. If there is any doubt in the rules, legal provisions and journal entry, you can ask now before solving the problem. Any doubts you can ask. You can chat, you can comment in the chat box also. We'll continue how to solve the problem. Now we need to see. So now, first there is a working note. Working note we need to do. So first working note is, what is your preference share capital? See the problem. Now you will find out your preference share capital. What is preference share capital? 5,000 into 10. That is your preference share capital. So preference share capital is 50,000. Now you know preference share capital is 50,000. Now how you are going to pay this? From where you are going to pay this? That means company, which balance company will utilize to pay preference share capital of 50,000? That is the question here. So for that purpose, it can use a fresh issue, or it can use profit, or it can use reserve. So there are three options. So in this problem, fresh issue information is given. What is fresh issue information? Company issued 2000 equity shares of 10 each at a premium of 2 per share. So that is nothing but fresh issue. New shares are issued for the purpose of redemption. So how to know the fresh issue amount? So in front of preference share capital, you need to write fresh issue of shares. That is nothing but 2000 into 10. 2000 into 10, that is 20,000. That is a fresh issue of share. Then still there is a balance left. So 20,000 you will utilize from fresh issue. 50,000 minus 20,000, 30,000 is remaining. Now which balance company will utilize to pay off preference share capital? The question itself states that the company has necessary balance in profit and loss account. That means what? Necessary balance in profit and loss means, so there is sufficient balance is there for the purpose of redemption. So n number of amount you can withdraw from profit and loss account. So here remaining balance, we will take it from profit and loss account, 30,000. So total fresh issue of share 20,000, profit and loss account 30,000. So total 50,000, these 50,000 is met for paying preference share capital. So preference share capital is 50,000. So it tallies now, 50,000 both the side. So next thing, redemption premium. So how to find out redemption premium? Now you know preference share capital is 50,000. So what is the redemption premium? If you take 50,000 into 10%, what is the amount? 5,000 you will get. That is redemption premium. 50,000 into 10%. Separately, you need to show redemption premium. Because journal entry we need to do separately, right? Redemption premium. So that is 5,000. So 5,000, from where you are going to utilize 5,000? What is the rule? Redemption premium account can be, for paying the redemption premium, you can utilize security premium account or profits. Security premium account or profits. So here, security premium account information is not given in the problem. Whether security premium account information is given in the problem, not given. But we can find out the security premium account information how? By seeing the fresh issue of share. If you see the this one condition, the company issued 2000 equity shares of 10 each at a premium of 2 per share. So here premium of 2 per share is given. That itself is a security premium account. No other balance is mentioned in the problem. So 2 per share means total number of equity share is given in the problem, that is 2000. 2000 into 2. So 4000 we are taking from security premium account. But redemption premium account is 5,000. So what we are going to do? From where we are going to get the remaining 1,000? So we can utilize from profit and loss account. So profit and loss account, sufficient balance is there. Remaining 1,000, we will take it from profit and loss account. So it's 4,000 plus 1,000, 5,000. Redemption premium amount is also 5,000. So it is met now. First we have met. First we have settled the preference share capital. Then we have settled redemption premium. This is how you need to show the working note. First preference share capital, what and all balance is utilized. Then redemption premium, what and all balance is utilized. So after doing this working note, what is next you need to do? What you need to do here is journal entry, passing the journal entry. You need to pass the journal entry. So do you need to do the format here, date, particular, ledger folio, debit amount and credit amount. So you need to do the format. First entry is for issue. So here issue means what issue? Issue of fresh issue of shares. So fresh issue of shares, you know, company issued 2000 equity shares of 10 each at a premium of 2 per share. So fresh issue is nothing but, what is the journal entry? Normal journal entry for fresh issue, bank account debit to equity share capital account. But it is issued at premium. So you need to add one more account, that is two security premium account. So bank account debit, two equity share capital account, two security premium account. So now equity share capital at par value 2000 into 10, that you will get 20,000. Premium, that is nothing but 2000 into 2, that is 4000. What is the total amount comes to the bank? That is 24,000. 20,000 plus 4,000, that is 24,000. You need to write the narration also for journal entry, being the fresh issue of equity share. Being the fresh issue of equity share. So that is the first journal entry. So next one, next journal entry is for amount due on redemption. Only one information is given about the issue. Next is amount due on redemption means what and all amount is to be given to the preference shareholder. One thing is capital, one more thing is premium. So two amount is to be given. So preference share capital account is debited here 50,000. Redemption premium account is again debited, that is 5,000. Two preference shareholder account. So here that is total 50,000 plus 5,000, that is 55,000, being the amount due on redemption. So from where we have got this amount? See, this preference share capital 50,000 we have taken and redemption premium 5,000 we have taken. So total 55,000 will be the amount due on redemption. Next, amount actually given to the preference shareholder. So what is the journal entry? Preference shareholder account to bank account. So this amount, that is 55,000, is given to the preference shareholder. So preference shareholder account debit to bank account 55,000, being the payment made on redemption. Being the payment made on redemption, that is third journal entry. Now fourth one, after doing this journal entry, we need to meet the redemption premium. So what is the redemption premium here? What is the redemption premium here? Redemption premium, if you see, that is 5,000 is a redemption premium. 5,000 is a redemption premium. So that balance we need to utilize. Redemption premium balance we need to utilize for the purpose of redemption. So redemption premium is here 5,000. So how to utilize that balance? Once you see security premium account. What is the security premium account here? 4,000. So 4,000 is taken from security premium and 1,000 is taken from profit and loss account. So total 5,000. So how we are going to meet the redemption premium? Security premium account debit 4,000, profit and loss account debit 1,000, to redemption premium, that is 5,000. Total 4,000 plus 1,000, being redemption premium met. Being redemption premium met, fourth journal entry. Fifth one, being redemption of capital out of profit. What is the rule? For being redemption of capital out of profit means amount equal to the nominal value of the shares must be transferred to capital reserve account, that is other than fresh issue. So that is only profits we need to consider and reserves we need to consider. So here profit and loss account debit to capital redemption reserve account. How to get this 30,000 amount? How to get this 30,000 amount? Once you need to go for the working note here, preference share capital 30,000, 50,000 we know, preference share capital 50,000 we know, fresh issue other than fresh issue. So you should not include fresh issue now and you consider only profit and loss account balance. So what is the profit and loss account balance utilized for the purpose of redemption? 30,000. So only 30,000 you need to consider. So profit and loss account balance account debit to capital redemption reserve account 30,000, being redemption of capital out of profits. So this is the way you are going to solve the problem. So this is a basic problem with journal entries. After that, what comes, that is journal entries along with the balance sheet also it is there. So these five journal entries, normal journal entries comes, and there is no information about bonus issue of share. If there is a bonus issue of share, bonus issue journal entry also comes in the problem. So this is how you are going to solve the problem. Now, whether there is any doubt, whether there is any doubt in the first question, you can ask the doubt now. You can ask the doubt whether I am going too fast. Yes. Do you want to explain me again? Yes. Should I explain it again? Yes. Okay. So now before explaining what I want to know, please unmute yourself and ask the doubt if you have any doubt if you have that I want to know now. Unmute yourself. Yes. 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 Teaching very fast.
Can't understand, sir.
Is it? So then any other doubts? Again, I should this one explain. So now what I will do is again I will explain the problem. So again we will see the screen now. We'll see the screen again. Yes. So while explaining, you can directly unmute yourself and ask me. Okay. While explaining, you can directly unmute yourself and ask me if there is any doubt. Whether that is fine? Yes. So again we will see the rules. See, first thing is the redemption of preference shares. So we have already explained the meaning of preference share. So what is preference share, you know? So preference shareholder will get the priority at the time of payment of dividend and at the time of repayment of capital during the winding up of the company. So here there is a concept of redemption of preference share. So what do you mean by redemption of preference share? Redemption means getting back. Getting back means what is the process first? First, company will issue the shares to the subscriber. So subscriber is nothing but shareholder. So shareholder will receive that share and he will pay some amount to the company, isn't it? So when company gives a redeemable preference share, what happens? After certain period, company has the right to take back the share. So that is known as redemption of preference share. Whenever the shares are taken back and the amount is paid to the shareholder, whether the company will give the same amount. So now you unmute yourself and ask. So now you ask the question, whether company will pay the same amount. Please unmute yourself. Yes. Yes, you can ask. Please unmute yourself and ask whether the company will pay the same amount to the shareholder after a certain time period, whether it will pay more or less. What is your opinion? What is your opinion? More or less? Unmute yourself, or in the chat box also you can answer. In the chat box also you can answer. Please answer it in the chat box, whether company will pay more or less after a certain time period to the shareholder. while buying back its own shares, that is redeemable preference share. So here what happens, company will basically pay more amount. So that is why now shares are issued at premium. So when the shares are issued at premium, what happens? So there is a redemption premium account is automatically opened. See, first there is a preference share capital. So let me say preference share capital is 1 lakh. Now it is issued at 10% premium. Means what? 1 lakh plus 10,000. 1 lakh plus 10,000 means what? 1 lakh 10,000 now. The amount before the shares are issued at 1 lakh. Now shares are issued at 1 lakh 10,000. Whether it is a profit or loss to the company? Anyone can answer whether it is a profit or loss to the company. When the shares are issued at premium, whether it is a profit or loss to the company, anyone can answer now. Unmute yourself and answer. Unmute yourself and answer. Anyone? Unmute yourself and answer, please. Whether it is a profit or loss to the company, when the shares are issued at premium, anyone can answer. If they have profit, they may pay more. Yes. So, yeah, whether it is profit or loss, I'm asking whether it is, how it is a profit, how it is a profit to the company. Company is paying more, right? When the company is paying more, it is a loss to the company. It is a loss to the company. Why? I will tell. First, the company is paying 1 lakh for preference share. Now, because of premium, company is to pay 1,10,000 to the shareholder. Along with the capital, company need to pay the premium also. So, extra 10,000 company need to pay. So, how that is a profit to the company? It is a loss to the company. It is a loss to the company whenever there is a premium amount. So, that is one thing you need to remember. So, now, various rules. So, we have discussed about redemption. Now various rules we need to see. Rules we have already discussed, that is first thing is partly paid share. In the question you need to see about partly paid share. If partly paid shares are not, if partly paid shares are there, then what happens? You need to convert into fully paid share. So now any doubt? Any doubt regarding the first rule? Any doubt you can ask? Any doubt you can ask? What do you mean? If there is any doubt regarding partly paid share and fully paid share, you can ask. No doubt? Yes. No doubt. In that case, what happens? Partly paid shares, if there is any partly paid shares, you need to convert into fully paid share. How to convert into fully paid shares? That we will see in upcoming problem. So we need to make one call that is known as final call. So final call, there is one journal entry. Then after that, all money is received. So there is one more journal entry you need to pass if there is a partly paid share. That is the first rule. Second rule, capital can be reduced, redeemed either out of profits of the company or out of the proceeds of fresh issue of share, but not out of debenture. So what is this rule? See the rule carefully. Profit or fresh issue, but not out of debenture. That means what? Not out of debenture means what? You can unmute yourself. Not out of debenture means you cannot utilize debenture value for the purpose of redemption. Only you can utilize fresh issue amount or profit and loss account information or general reserve information, and no other thing you can utilize. So that is the very important rule. Second one. Third one. Preference shares are either redeemed at par or at premium, but not at discount. Why? Preference share cannot be redeemed at discount. What is the reason? Anyone unmute yourself? What is the reason? Why preference shares cannot be issued at discount? What is the reason? What is the reason? Why preference shares cannot be issued at discount? Whether shareholder will agree to get the less amount from the company, whether they will agree to get the less amount at the time of redemption, they will not agree. Of course, they want at least par value or more value. Par value or premium value, but not the discounted value. Yes, yes. So, because of that, what happens? We need to issue this redemption of preference share only at par and premium, not at discount. Next, fourth one, the premium payable on redemption of must be provided either out of profit or out of security premium account. So premium on redemption means here what premium we are talking? We are talking about redemption premium. So redemption premium, if you see the problem once, redemption premium, if you see this redemption premium 5000 we have got from the preference share capital. So for this purpose we can utilize only two balance, one is security premium account and one more is profit and loss account. That is one more condition, only security premium and profit and loss account we can utilize. So now can you tell me how to find out the security premium information? Can you tell me how to find out the security premium information? Anyone can answer. Unmute yourself and answer. Please answer now. Unmute yourself and answer. How to find security premium information from the problem? How to find security premium information? Yes, here lot of people are there, 16 people. So yes, anyone can answer, right? Yes, unmute yourself and answer. Anyone can answer. You can answer. Or you can type it in the chat box also. So now, see, this is about security premium account I am talking. Security premium account we can find by seeing, yes, premium, correct. Premium on equity share. Premium on equity share we can see. From that information, we get security premium account. So premium on equity share is nothing but at the time of fresh issue. Fresh issue information we need to see. So yes, that is correct. Then capital is redeemed out of profit. Amount equal to the nominal value shall be transferred to capital redemption reserve. Why amount equal to the nominal value is transferred? Why amount equal to the nominal value is transferred? Only for the purpose of issuing bonus shares. We can utilize CRR balance. So how to utilize CRR balance other than the fresh issue, only profit information. If you see the problem once, you will come to know. See the problem, you will come to know now. So preference share capital is 50,000 is given. Fresh issue is 20,000 we have taken from the problem. So this other than the fresh issue means only profit and loss account information 30,000 we need to consider for the purpose of CRR. That we need to transfer this amount P&L account to CRR, capital redemption reserve account. That is the fifth condition. Then sixth one, capital redemption, yes, it can be used for bonus share. That is, you know, that redemption of preference share should not be taken for reduction, that we have already discussed. Internal reconstruction, it is not the case of internal reconstruction, it is a separate case of redemption. Company has the power to issue the shares up to the nominal number of shares redeemed. Yes, that is true. When fresh shares are issued for the purpose of redemption, it will not be considered as increase in capital. Yes, why it is not considered as increase in capital? What is the reason? Anyone can answer now. What is the reason? Fresh shares are not considered as increase in capital or addition to the capital. Why? Why? Yes, unmute yourself. Unmute yourself and answer. Why it is not considered as increase in capital or addition to the capital? Why it is not considered? You can answer. Why it is not considered? Why it is not considered? You can comment also. In the chat box, you can comment also. What is the reason? There must be some reason, right? Why fresh issue is not added to the equity share capital? Because it is utilized. It is utilized for paying the redemption of capital. That is, when a company is paying the redemption capital, what happens? It will utilize the fresh issue amount. That is why fresh issue cannot be, we cannot treat it as what? Increase in capital. So, any doubts now? Any doubts regarding the rules? Please open up. Any doubts regarding the rules? Any doubts regarding the rules? Any doubts regarding the rules? Please unmute yourself and answer. Please answer. Any doubts regarding the rules? No, no doubts regarding the rules. Yes, no doubts regarding the rules. So now you know the rules. Now next thing you need to know is journal entry. Journal entry and what and all we can consider for the purpose of redemption. So see, general reserve account we can consider, dividend equalization, workmen compensation. See, all these things, debenture redemption, contingency reserve, insurance, credit balance, that means profit balance, we can consider for the purpose of redemption. So these things are just, you need to know, that's it. Only what and all you need to consider. What and all you cannot consider, profit and forfeited share account you cannot use, security premium account you cannot use. Why you cannot use security premium account? You can use it only for the redemption premium. Balance of capital reserve, that is also you cannot use. Profit payout to incorporation, anyways, you cannot use. So now journal entry, if you see the journal entry, so shall we see the journal entry again? Shall we see the journal entry again? Shall we see the journal entry again? Yes, yes, we'll see the journal entry again now. Accounting treatment, first one is issue. So I told earlier, issue, what is the journal entry? Basic entry, that is bank account debit to equity share capital, that is a basic entry. Whenever there is an issue of share may be either fresh issue, that's fresh issue also same thing. So that is issued at par. So this entry you know. Now issued at premium, same entry. This same entry, along with that there is one addition. What is that addition? Whenever there is a premium, there is one more account is added, that is security premium account is added. And you know, security premium account has a credit balance. So two security premium account, bank account debit, two equity share capital, two security premium, that is issued at a premium. If it is issued at premium, usually in the problem it will be at premium or at par, but not at a discount. So you can use this entry. If it is at discount, discount has a debit balance. So bank account debit, discount on issue of shares account debit to equity share capital. So this is three entries for issue, depending on the nature of the problem. You need to see whether it is par, whether it is at premium, whether it is at discount. Then now next is amount due on redemption. So what and all amount preference shareholder will get? So two things he will get. One is capital, one is premium. So preference share capital account debit, redemption premium account debit to preference shareholder. That is the journal entry for amount due on redemption. Same amount due on redemption is actually paid to the preference shareholder. How it is paid to the preference shareholder? By utilizing the bank account. So from the bank, we are giving to the preference shareholder. So preference shareholder account debit to bank account. That is the third journal entry. Payment made to preference shareholder. Then fourth one, for meeting redemption premium. How to meet redemption premium? So there are two ways in which we can meet redemption premium, isn't it? How we can meet redemption premium? Either out of security premium account or out of profit and loss account. So we consider both the things. So that is why it is debited. Security premium account debit, profit and loss account debit to redemption premium account. So that is for meeting redemption premium. Fifth one, for redemption of capital out of profit, that means other than the fresh issue. Other than the fresh issue means profit and reserves only. So these balance must be transferred to CRR. So profit and loss account debited, revenue reserve is debited to capital redemption reserve account. This balance is transferred. Why it is transferred? For issuing bonus share. See, for issue of bonus share. When the decision is taken to issue the bonus share, capital redemption account is debited to bonus to equity shareholder account. Redemption account to bonus to shareholder account. When decision is taken, actually bonus share is issued, debit the receiver. So who is receiving? So bonus to equity shareholder. Equity shareholder is receiving the bonus share to equity share capital, credit the giver. So equity share capital is given in the form of bonus share. So these are the journal entry you need to know. So now any doubt regarding the journal entries? Any doubt regarding the journal entries? You can ask now any doubt regarding the journal entries. Fast, you can answer, unmute yourself, you can answer. Any doubt regarding the journal entry, you can comment in the chat box also. Any doubts regarding the journal entry? No doubts? Any doubts regarding the journal entry? No doubts, right? Sure? Yes. So now we'll see that problem. One fast look, we will see that problem. See this, we have already seen this problem. AB Limited had 5,000 redeemable preference shares of 10 each. So we know the preference share capital, that is 50,000. But 50,000, how we are going to see from fresh issue of shares? That is given 2,000 into 10, that is 20,000. Profit and loss account, they have said sufficient balance, so 30,000. So 20 and 30, you will get 50,000. So that is preference share capital. Again, one more working note you need to do, that is redemption premium account, that is nothing but 50,000 into 10%. That is premium value is given, 10%. So that is 50,000 into 10%, that is 5,000. From which balance you can utilize? Security premium and profit and loss account balance you can utilize. So security premium and profit and loss account balance 4,000 and 1,000 we have taken. So that is 5,000. Journal entry, I told, first we have discussed in this problem there is issue redemption at premium is given. So if you see the journal entry, bank account to equity share capital to security premium. Now already we have discussed the journal entry. As per that we are going to solve. Then preference shareholder, what and all you will get? Capital and premium. So that is debited and credit preference shareholder account. Then actual amount is received, so preference shareholder to bank. Then redemption premium only out of 2, premium and profit and loss account balance, so that is debited to redemption premium. Then last one is other than fresh issue transfer to capital redemption reserve account, that is only profit. Fresh issue 20,000 is not considered. Yes, so this is the class for today. I am going to stop the recording now.